When we are looking here at all the different texts of Buddhism, then within that we can see how the Buddha has presented many different topics, including topics that refer to phenomena, like to things, to physical things, and so forth. But anyway, anything that he was presenting here, he is presenting with reasons, with logic, and so forth. Yeah, so that people can use this and by this logic then analyze the situations or analyze what the Buddha is proposing, and in this way come to an actual experience of these things that the Buddha is describing, so that they actually can have an experience in the form of what is called a valid cognition of these phenomena. And there is as has been said, within all this presentation of the Buddha, there is also a presentation of the basis, which are the what is called the things, yeah, so the general phenomena. And so here you have a great accordance or harmony between what the Buddha is saying and what nowadays scientists are saying. Yeah, so what the scientist, or the other way around, what the scientists are saying seems to be in accordance with what the Buddha had said way back. And so science, of course, is something very strong in nowadays in the world of today, and yet the science improves on a daily basis and also needs to improve more and more. So that's the one thing that science is still in the process of improving more and more. The other thing is that His Holiness makes very clear that here that what is said in Buddhism, what we find in Buddhism, needs to accord with that what the scientists find. Yeah, so what the scientists find is accepted as being the case, and then whatever is said in Buddhism needs to be measured against that. And so even 30, maybe even 40 years ago, His Holiness was talking about that all these findings that we that the Buddha was presenting, all these insights that Buddha was presenting, would be something that one should make an effort to bring this into science, that it becomes a part of science, and in this way also spread like science. And so this is kind of one of the intentions of His Holiness when he has brought forth, started this project, that these texts that we are going to look in are produced. And so His Holiness himself said to Geshe personally three times that he should teach this text that was produced here. And so it means that he should teach the text, he should go through the text, he should lead people through this text and so forth. So up to now, this has never happened. So now this is the occasion where Geshe wants to follow this instruction or advice from His Holiness.
That Dang Bu Di Gyao Rum Shin Kuran La Di Ne Kantis Ta Tsiri Tol Tona Kantis Le Bar Re Se Je Tendek Tuna Ta Lukyu Rup Te Shu Ni Sirwa.
So first, Geshe would like a little bit to relate kind of the history or the story, how it happened that His Holiness himself generated interest in science, how His Holiness came to this interest in science. So even when His Holiness was still of a very small age, even then he was had a great liking for machines and mechanisms, and was always very interested in these. And then His Holiness came to Tibet, came to India, and so then in India then he encountered science and was also quite interested in what science has to say and made some effort to understand more about science.
Then, that Tsenri Dan, Nangbe Chuk Parage, Parala Kebar Kardu.
And so then the interest was such that His Holiness wanted to know what's the difference between science and Buddha Dharma? And how do they relate to each other? Are they benefiting each other? Are they giving benefit to each other? Or otherwise, if not, then what's the relation between them? What's the difference between them and so forth? So with that in mind, His Holiness tried to understand more and more, get himself educated in science. And so then His Holiness was actually meeting outstanding scientists in person and then talking and discussing with them. Again, a lot of understanding was generated.
Okay.
And so when His Holiness was encountering therefore science and scientists, then he saw how the scientists are really analyzing, yeah, and coming to results in accordance with logic, yeah, and they really their findings are pretty stable, yeah, pretty reliable. And so seeing this, then His Holiness felt like that this is something we can rely on, and this is something we can also relate on. And he also felt quite confident in encountering science, such that he felt like science is not kind of harming or degenerating Buddha Dharma in any way, yeah, but actually there can be a mutual support. So the point of this is that other religions, it can happen that if they interact with science, this actually degenerates this other system, yeah, or refutes this other system. So His Holiness did not have this feeling that science is kind of contradicting the Buddha Dharma, and so that's what was meant with this confidence that he had, that one can really exchange with scientists. Yeah, they are not. This is not harmful. This is beneficial. His Holiness Dalai Lama is very often pointing out that the Buddha himself said the following. He said, like, bhikshus, do not take what I'm saying on the basis of seeing me as something very honorable, but you have to take my teachings and check them like gold. And then when you check them and you find them to be worthwhile, then you can accept them. So this checking like gold is what the Buddha is using here as an analogy, is if somebody would want to buy gold and something is presented to him like, this is gold, do you want to buy this? Then you would not just buy this for a high price, obviously, but you would actually kind of first of all just look at it and check if it looks like gold, if it has the obvious qualities of gold. But then there might be some pollution inside, or something might be manipulated inside the lump of gold. So you wanna cut it in pieces to see if inside it's pure gold. And then still there might be some kind of good fake gold. But then there is a method of rubbing the gold and see how it reacts to that. Yeah, and so by this also then you can find out, it's another method to find out if something is gold. So applying all these methods, you then find out that it is gold, and then when you have this conviction, only then you accept it and you pay that price. So in other words, you have checked if there's any faults, and when you have found out that there is no faults, then you accept it. So His Holiness says, so here the same thing needs to be done, as the Buddha said himself, with regard to the teachings of the Buddha. Yeah? They need to be analyzed, and strongly. Yeah? So first of all, we can see how the Buddha has actually taught many different systems. Yeah, he has all these Vaibhashikas and so forth. He has taught different systems which are not saying the same thing. So he has not said the same thing all the time. So we cannot just take it. We need to analyze. And we need to analyze again, just like in this example, with actually observing it, or weighing it, or measuring, and then cutting, and then rubbing the gold. So similar here, with regard to things that he says for the so-called manifest phenomena, then here directly, with our normal perception, we can see if that what he says about manifest phenomena is valid or not. Then there is things which are called hidden phenomena, and so here we need to actually analyze with logic and use our wisdoms, use our brains, and by this analysis then we can even understand if what he says about hidden phenomena is correct or not. And then there is even something which is called the very hidden phenomena, and even that we need to check if it is harmed by other texts or by other quotations, something that he said somewhere else. Yeah, so we have to put it into relation. Yeah? And in this way, we actually kind of check it directly by cutting and by rubbing, in other words, by analyzing and by comparing it to other things that have been said. And only if it is withstanding this thorough analysis, then we can finally accept what is said here. And this is also the way that we should do it, and not by way of having great respect for the Buddha or having kind of a very strong kind of faith without analyzing beforehand, because this kind of faith that you would, if you accept something what the Buddha said, just because of faith, without having analyzed, then this becomes like a faith that is a blind faith, or a stupid faith, actually.
Thank you. Kerala Nishi Nyen, thank you. Shuna Tante Tagara, said Tashi Chetuegi. Majung, the Majung Bado Chabachabres.
And so, therefore, with regard to everything that the Buddha has taught, yeah, like let's say the scriptures or the sayings of the Buddha, so everything that has been expressed, yeah, the subject matter of all these different sayings or writings, need to be analyzed. Yeah? And they need to be analyzed such that you are finally getting what is called a definite understanding, a definite realization, different knowledge about this topic. Yeah? And then when you have that, on that basis you can have a faith that is based on this definite understanding. So until then, up to the point where you have not yet generated this definite knowledge, you have to continue analyzing. So the point is that an attitude where you say, I am a follower of the Buddha, I am therefore accepting what the Buddha is saying, because I have faith in the Buddha, I'm a follower of the Buddha, yeah? This is not the right attitude. This is not the way to do things. So here the correct attitude is that what the Buddha has said needs to be analyzed. We need to use analytical tools and kind of bring this analysis to the to its end, to go see it through. And so we need to get so far that we actually get decided about this point. We are clear about this point.
Mm-hmm.
So to say like this is what the Buddha said, or this comes from a Buddhist text, or from a text stemming from the Buddha, this is not becoming a valid reason in any kind of statement.
What he Buddha ke labja de hal leverest hal leverage one de tende sungye ke tamba chane yes harwa.
So this teaching of the Buddha saying exactly that is really outstanding. This is really too much. Where is there another teacher who would say something like this about his teaching? So here, this presentation of phenomena of things which are called the bases, yeah, the different bases. So here, such a presentation of phenomena, such that it is bearing analysis, yeah, and you can invite anybody come and analyze this, yeah, discuss this, yeah, take it apart, analyze it, and so forth. And if you do this in a correct way. Yeah, if you analyze correctly, apply logic and reason correctly, you will find out that it's like that. Yeah. So this is a very sound presentation.
Nalanda keba gumbo ludo yasala sova tadagi gyan kebe gumbo namge tuen kanchi chihimba yina yang chuche tuen kanchi chihimba yina tila pe cheba chasha. Musung hakoyajida, rang nyola ketuish. Tendichi, you know, keleje. Tendichi, you know, kelemeje. The Nalanda Rodanes, right?
And so, also, when we look at the scholars of Nalanda in the past, yeah, then from their example, we can see the way things were done in Nalanda, yeah, the Nalanda way of things, of doing things. And you can see that all these great scholars like Nagarjuna and his spiritual offspring, his spiritual sons, so they would all take what the Buddha has said and really analyze deeply. Yeah? And then with this process of analyzing and dealing with these propositions or these teachings of the Buddha, take it so far that they have a certain understanding and even a direct realization of these things. Yeah? So this is the way of the Nalanda tradition, that you actually analyze deeply, and only when you have analyzed and found it correct, only then you accept it.
And
so when we look at the procedure that was used in the glorious Nalanda, then scholars of the Nalanda tradition saying like, so this and this is the case, because that's what the Buddha said here in that scripture, or the Buddha says so. Yeah, this never can be a reason in the Nalanda tradition, never ever. Yeah, so therefore here this glorious Nalanda tradition is actually dependent of this tradition, would actually base themselves of analyzing everything what the Buddha said. So if different from that, or opposite to that, somebody would just come and would just kind of accept what the Buddha says, or would take as a reason that it's like that because the Buddha said so, or it says so here in the scripture and so forth, then this is then not a way of proceeding that is of sharp faculties, but you could say it's the way of proceeding of somebody who's a little of dull or of obscured faculties.
Mm-hmm.
And if there would be somebody who would proceed in that way, that he is just saying the Buddha said so, then it is clear that he is not falling into the folder of the Nalanda tradition. And so this is similar to actually what's happening in the world of science. Yeah? The scientists, they actually analyze their respective subject or what they are guiding their analysis towards. They analyze it and into great, great detail. Yeah? They go into great profundity and they really check it out and they do a lot of calculations. There's mathematical correctness in that and so forth. And only when in the end the thing is really kind of understood, is really analyzed, decisively analyzed, and can be accepted to be like this and that, only then they would hold this or base themselves on this kind of finding. So this is exactly the way how the Nalanda tradition proceeds, just like this analysis in science. And so the scientists, when they would be asked, so why would you say this and this? Why would you hold this and this? And then the scientist saying, I'm saying this because somebody else said it. You know, this would never happen in science. Yeah. So same with the Nalanda tradition. And so then when we talk about physical phenomena, things that we can actually see or directly encounter with a human normal capacity, yeah? Just with our normal consciousnesses, then here there is no discrepancy with what scientists are saying about these physical, visible, audible, and so forth objects. But then also with regard to things that are a hidden phenomenon, such that the human mind cannot immediately, directly perceive them. So. In the case of the Buddhists, with regard to such hidden phenomena, like for example very subtle particles or something, this world would be engaged by way of what is called an inferential cognition. Yeah, so by this thinking and analyzing and then generating an inferential cognition with regard to these hidden phenomena of the physical world. And they would come to certain results, and the scientists, on top of that, they would not just use kind of inferential cognitions or thoughts, but they also have all kind of tools, like microscopes and so forth, or all kind of different tools, and by this they get their findings, and these findings, again, this is all all what Geshe is saying is right, His Holiness writing here in the first pages. Yeah? His Holiness says that these findings of the scientists accord with what is held here in Buddhism, which is found not with these tools, but simply on the basis of inferential cognition.
And so,
when His Holiness saw this situation, that here these findings about, let's say, particles and so forth that came out of Buddhism or the Nalanda tradition, and the findings of science were in accordance, were in harmony with each other, then His Holiness felt like, so this is really something I can go along with, yeah? So this is something that is in harmony with my own system, and I can actually rely on this. Yeah, and I can rely on this. I have the confidence of not being afraid of science or kind of having to shun science, but be able to go with them in discussion or even depending on, like, basing myself on them, because they come to findings that over 2,000 years ago, even the protector Nagarjuna and his spiritual offspring were also coming to in the Nalanda tradition. And so then here the scientist using on the one hand tools and fine instruments like microscopes and so forth, and on the other hand also using calculation mathematics, then on that basis they understood the situation, or they understood reality on that basis, and they could understand many forms and shapes, or maybe better to say it as many different structures. Yeah, and so forth. And so in this way of proceeding, they were even able to go to very, very subtle levels of understanding. And so they did this especially by relying on the normal human faculty, like the eye consciousness, and then supplementing it by all these devices and instruments, which kind of give the human eye, for example, a much more far-reaching capacity to actually analyze and understand things. And then in this way they were able the scientists were able to understand many situations or many realities that normally are reached by inferential cognition. So they did this either in this way of microscope and so forth, or by using inferential cognition themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And so by doing this kind of analysis, yeah, so all this analysis, of course, is something which involves the mind. Yeah? The mind is doing this analysis. Yeah? And so by doing this analysis, then this experience could come about that things are definitely like this. Yeah, things could be established. Yeah, they could be decided upon. Yeah, this and this is the reality. So regardless if anyone else also knows these phenomena or understands this, it doesn't matter. It is established like that through this ways of reasoning. And so this is exactly also what you do in Buddhism. Yeah? You do a lot of analysis and you analyze again and again and you take the analysis further to other subjects and so forth and you build on it these different analysis on each other and all of this is aiming at to get an actual understanding, an actual penetrative insight, yeah? To get a real mind that is certain about these, yeah? To establish things. And so everything that is described here in this text of Buddhism is actually aiming at an experience, yeah, an experiential understanding. Yeah, so it's not just there for merely knowing or merely kind of dealing with it or thinking about it or something, but it is really aiming at going through this process of approaching the phenomenon by listening, by reflecting, and then also by cultivating, so that you finally can have such an actual experience with regard to the object.
Chebe tar dene, nyual tunerwa, kenecheba nashinchi, and nangbe shuna lane, toba the samba the kumbala sol of that, and rimba cheba la tene, tame tachodi, than nyual tukovati. Nyual tu, si chigi kumjung shibe or tu, such the chigi, tampukuran the chishin of chigi or unzida, tendegi tone, tachigine, did it, such a gun. What did she love that she mato chigi? Tendam wish she was a shell.
Yeah, so this this word experience, what I translated experience, the meaning of this in this context is that you have a definite understanding, yeah, that you established something, yeah, you're clear about this now. So in the scientific world, you would do this by way of doing these experiments and going through these processes with instruments and so forth, and not only that, but also using all kind of mathematics and so forth. And in this way, you would establish something and come to an experience in the sense of that you actually establish things. So here in Buddhism, you would come to this kind of experience or such a consciousness that is certain about the respective phenomenon by way of what is called listening, reflecting, and cultivating.
Mangu da den tu zhe na qi, ruwa? Da kong de cheng ri ke be ming de de mang du, de ne ming ga gu men da, ne, gar sa, skar, po, 포베 인에서 지도하고 하고 됐던 단 저명 신진 빈자듯이 네 신다스도 양자
카레 카레 쿵쿵이 카레
다비드 봄 사실
다비드 봄
코나 민게 가인사 갈갈 봄
오칼 칼
웨즈카
Okay, so tikare lo tunju dosum chungso.
Ah, chino ko dintun son al chungso.
So in 1973, if I understood this right, His Holiness was coming for the first time to the West, and as he was coming to the West, he was also encountering different Western scientists, and so they're mentioned here with their Western name in Tibetan transliteration in the text. And then there opens a bracket and it's written in Latin letters, because otherwise it's a little bit difficult to see. So the first one that's mentioned here was Sir Karl Popper. Yeah. So this was one. I think he's actually more of a philosopher and not a scientist, really. But anyway, so this is mentioned here. And then the brother of a former German president, so this scientist is called Karl von Weizsäcker. Weizsäcker. Karl von Weizsäcker. And then somebody else, another scientist called David Bohm. So he encountered all of these, like a personal encounter, and they had this exchange.
Ah, Konsutan Yamdo, Tudrechene, then Arazin Chiding, Ganjidin Kamp Namshadi. That, ne? Chiki leze namsha. Lebe naga zai.
Nga
zai intro da. Rua? Tad ne, kengwe gri. Chi ngobo. Shing da chu da zada chi yorwa. Gewe ri.
Gewe ri.
Wade ngo ze gri yorwa. Wade ne gri da. Dine, nguan kam, ta karsula, ta tu chingin namsha.
And so in these encounters, there was they discussed many things. So literally, it says they were talking about the world, which I guess is something like geology or something like this, or astronomy or something. And then they were talking about the brain and nerves, which is probably neuroscience. And then they talked about everything of the growing type, which is probably biology and zoology or something. Is. And then they talked about dürgen, which is particles. Yeah. So I don't know, atom physics and so forth.
That is really that to change really. Then, since the time when I was in college, I was that Thomas, Chaba, Thomas, large ones.
So here, the scientist expressed to His Holiness that if you are exploring this situation of particles more and more, and you go into more and more subtle, you find a certain level, you go even further, that level, and so forth. In the end, you lose the particle. In the end, there's nothing there. Yeah. So in other words, they came to a statement that there is nothing really there on the external side. So they wouldn't say this is because it depends on the consciousness. Yeah? So they wouldn't make that statement. But with this statement that by analyzing more and more, then there's nothing there. Therefore, things are not established on the external side. They sounded a little bit like the Chittamatrins. Yeah. So there seems there was. Seems like His Holiness saw a similarity to the Chittamatrins.
And the Senzambe Tawa de Kandichila, we are a sonna Chirugi su kaya bandi Chirung when a tena Nigimares Kerala now nunsu dana shinshi Kerang nunsu kaya bandi Zagadone Nigimares. The kinds 나 시베 다니도요.
응 시베?
시베 다니도요. 시베 바자 세베 더 주고요. 가해서 치료는 이게 말했어. 나 치료는 이게 뭔도 없어요. 콘도 집어라고요. 나 시베 다니도요. 여바다 콘도 라고요.
닭니 둘라나? 랑신
시베 랑신 시베 다 세지.
So then let's look for a moment what we are saying in our systems when we talk about the Chittamatra system. So here we would say with regard to a form that is established on the external side, if you would look for that, a form that is established on the external side, complete thing, then you would not find that. Yeah? And so we would say this is because this form is actually not established on the external side, but it's in the nature of mind. Yeah, so we would say that it's an imprint ripening and so forth, and that this form is not a different substance from the mind perceiving it and so forth. So anyway, we would have this this statement that such a form on the external side cannot be found. Yeah, if you analyze this, if you look for it, it cannot be found. And this is because it's actually dependent on the mind, it's in the nature of the mind. So the scientist would not go that far that they would say it's dependent on the mind, but they would say this external form is lost, cannot be found on the analysis.
Not find.
Zelna, zelna, den rang une duberes. Dirba. Okay, so dark dun zelna. So
that duten zesong, celibate duten to zega chisong. Zel is not tari nimosong. Omen shun alana, shun woman amsha digedi. How was that? Now, on a sense, you get a net,
And so, then Geshe presents something out of the Madhyamika system. So, here they were saying that if something is established from its own side, then it would mean that that would mean that you can find the imputed meaning. Something like that. Yeah? So this is not the case. Yeah? If you look for this imputed meaning, then you cannot find it. And so therefore things are not established from their own side. And so Geshe brings this up because there is this word, if you find it. Yeah? So in other words, you look for something and then you find it. So here this is exactly what the scientists did. Yeah? They were looking for these kind of particles. And the more they were looking for it, the less they could find it. Actually in the end it was gone, it had dissolved. Yeah? So there's exactly this process of looking for it and not finding it. Therefore, according to the Madhyamika, not existing from its own side.
Then they do. Another, Nangbe Shune, Tachigi, Shege, da, Tana Shineta Hadon said, Kishigero. How was that? What the Nigi Shineta Hadon said, that the Nigi Namsha, Tan Nangbe Shune Shege. Sengham shiba. Seng namsha, ruwa. Seng namsha dunbe dine, sim sinjung namsha dunbe da nangbe shungi. Na sengham shiba se ting ingi rwe. Sem da simjung namsha, lurig namsha, yorba. Wo digi tola, ta be tsini da,
So then we have in Buddhism, of course, also this presentation of calm abiding, of special insight, and so forth. So all of this would come in what is called the knowledge of the mental realm. So normally you would translate this as psychology. Yeah, but obviously we're talking about things that normal psychology does not cover. They don't talk about calm abiding and special insight. Yeah, so therefore, let's talk about knowledge of the mind or something like this instead of saying psychology, because it's not just our Western psychology. So we're talking about this knowledge about the mental realm, if you like, which has calm abiding, has a special insight, has the presentation of mind and mental factors and so forth. So everything that we have in our topic, which is called Lorik or knowers and awarenesses. And so when His Holiness met these many scientists, the scientists showed a very great interest in that aspect. Yeah, they wanted to know about Buddhist psychology, if you like, you know, about this presentation of mind and mental factors and so forth.
What is that? Cenrig, then Zambuling, Cenrig, Sundu, Kerashim, Sodugama, and Yarum Chenga, the pen, and Sundu, Nimshu Naja, and Tito Tato, and Shivaji.
And so I don't know what this is referring to, but the Geshe says that this, there is some kind of very important or famous. Okay, tulin lop dori bedi.
Cenri kaba. Cenri kata chambo. Cenri ba kata chambo.
Tenzo kenzo dune.
Ah, dune. Chondo.
Din angla kari kong
pa.
Yeah, so it's not a university what we're speaking about now, but we talk about an association or an assembly of famous scientists, and so amongst these, His Holiness was invited and was asked to talk about these topics. So he presented these topics amongst these scholars or scientists.
That choice is that way, you know, and
And so then His Holiness goes on saying that science is kind of established or growing or present since like 300 years. Yeah. So during these 300 years, it's there, it's developing, it's growing, and it's very well established now, and it will grow even more. Yeah, it will find more things, and it will be more present for everybody. So this being the situation, yeah, then it is impossible to go down a lane and saying like, oh, maybe science is harming Buddhism or something. I just going to pass over it. Yeah? I'm not going to look at it. Yeah, because it's not going to go away. It is clearly established. It's there. The only way to move forward is going in it. Yeah, have not any hope that we can just pause over it and kind of do away with it or something. It is clearly established. And so then on the basis of all of this, somebody might say, yeah, here, I would actually, why not, I would listen to this, you know, I have a little bit of an interest in this science thing. Not like this, full-hearted going into science. You need to know science, you need to understand what science is saying, not just a little bit, yeah, would be interesting, why not, but really kind of going for it.
Uh-huh.
And so there is a path for entering into science with a lot of confidence due to being a Buddhist. Yeah? On basing yourself on Buddha Dharma, gaining great confidence, and with that going into science. This is possible. This is a way of proceeding. And so, Geshe's, His Holiness, the Lama says that nowadays, actually, it is starting that there is such a knowledge of the mental realm building up in the West also. Yeah. So, therefore, I don't want to say psychology because we have this since a long time. But he's talking about that now there is a certain interest and a certain scientific approach with regard to this, all the possibilities in the mental realm. So, here, His Holiness sees that now science could actually build up to this new field of this mental realm, exploring the mental realm.
Tenda kares na nganazo misi di doba kares digi dirabas nganazo misi gin doba digi dirabas mindo ba dumi dirabas ako sa tenda yinba yindi wala al tango dilata.
And so the point is simply this, that what we are looking for in life is happiness and joy. What we don't want is suffering.
Wo dilata na ta dile ta ba yin chen ri gi thwa ne ta kha su ra ta thang ge ta kha su ra chen ri gi thwa ne pa chu ma me le di gi chu ma ta kha ma ngo chi yi ba da ngu sung thung gu ar ba su ra.
And so that being the case, this being the goal of everybody, then we can clearly, manifestly see how science is planting many causes for some happiness to come about. It's visible to everybody, it's manifest. And so to the way that science has increased and has ameliorated, then here there's more and more benefit actually coming. And so again, what is actually the aim or the goal or the purpose of science? It is in order to bring forth more happiness, joy, well-being of sentient beings. So that being the case, again, due to this situation, His Holiness again felt like, I'm going to go into science, yeah, because it is bringing the benefit. I'm going to into science, yeah, and going so far that sometimes he says, I'm a scientist.
And so, therefore,
out of this all situation has been explained now. Nowadays, we are in a situation where there's kind of a little bit coming off the ground, a little bit starting. There's a science about the mental realm, yeah, the mental phenomena. And so this is actually something, therefore, that can be completely in harmony and go along with science, can be a part of science.
Today, lula tembe tige da sen la tembe tige ni ngudus tige ni budi tige ni budela ni kata gugudus sene gugudu sanga jebe napshet gugudus ra.
And so if such a union of what we normally refer to when we talk about science, maybe about material things, and then that together with a science of the mental phenomena, if this can come about, then here this is really a very strong power to bring about the benefit, the happiness, the joy, the well-being of the sentient beings. This is because there is two types of well-being or happiness. So one is a physical well-being and the other one is a mental well-being. Yeah, and both of them is what we need. We need both of these aspects. And so if you have both the physical science or the what we normally refer to as science, and also together with this a science or a knowledge of the mental phenomena, then this can actually serve the beings with regard to bringing forth both benefits. And so therefore, if we are working together with a scientist, yeah, so that there's really this union combination of this normal science, yeah, with regard to external phenomena, and on the other hand, a knowledge of the mental phenomena, then here really these two benefits of the sentient beings can be achieved, and there can be a really kind of the purposes of the, of beings can be brought about.
Ne inde yavrum için ki kurang mana dene ta lo mangu nala tsere chana tsere kyaba chig mangu da tuje na je gudur cheve gedene myun da de zo ni yesu ra.
And so then His Holiness goes on saying that when he kind of went for this study of science, yeah, and really kind of showed an interest and met scientists and exchanged with them in order to understand science and so forth, then he had actually two aims in mind.
And
so the first aim is always explained in the following way. So in general, we can
see.
So in the world we can see that there is many objects of knowledge or many things that that can be explored, many phenomena are around, and there will be even more in the future. So Geshe uses this example, if we reflect on how many cars are produced by Germany and then think about how many more they will produce in the future. Yeah, so that we can see that there's going to be a lot of phenomena. But Dalai himself doesn't have a car. Samsara, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So the science, yeah, from the very start, yeah, used the scientific method, but it was from the very start focusing on outer phenomena.
Tende yindu tadunyang seni ge chishib chega kabla chaba chega kabla chaba na shibtabo chega kabla ta sujin yongo ba tge zo zo tsigdu.
And so this is how it started with science, and even up to now, yeah, in the present day, still they are mainly interested in this outer phenomena, physical and the physical world. And so they are slowly exploring things of the substance type. Yeah, they're exploring substances.
Yinayang. Chaba chigenge kansa rani tola sang jom dang mendos kansa rani tol chaba chizu kanda tol te sang dang mendos kansa rani ki didu ko chwa tola sang dang mendos kunzo chaba chigenge mendos kunzo be chilu te shi te sama.
And so why they are doing this analysis, yeah, with regard to these many outer phenomena, what they don't do is an analysis of the person who does the analysis. And they do not do analysis of the mind analyzing. And they do not analyze with having a project or a question. So how is it that later on I remember what I analyzed before? And they do not analyze with regard to happiness and suffering of the analyzer. And so since the start until now, and maybe also in the future, the scientists are mainly or actually only looking at these external phenomena, at this physical phenomena. And so they are analyzing in this way, and the result is that indeed the understanding of outer phenomena is now incredibly high, very, very elevated. So while this is the case, if we then actually just analyze into society and see where we are, yeah, how it's going for everybody, then we can see that such an analysis of solely the physical phenomena or the outer phenomena is not enough. Yeah, is not fulfilling. Is not completely reaching the purpose.
And so
because this achievements of science, this understanding of the physical world, of the physical phenomena, is not sufficient when we check on the beings living in our society, on the individual people. Therefore, what we need is an education of the people in society that is not just an education about physical phenomena, but an education that has, together with this knowledge about physical phenomena, also a knowledge about the realm of the mental phenomena. Yeah? So this needs to come in order to really bring about the benefit for everybody in society.
Lekha chidang shirwa. 디돌아 아 시든 관티셰 시작이요네스와
So at the center, of course, it is true that the scientists are talking about the brain, and they tell you something about the brain. They talk about the nerves and the nervous system, the nerves in the brain, and so forth. And they tell you something about the processes that are happening there.
전당무시 가인상 이루 이기시 봤어요. 나도 노래 듣는데 오면 시마 망고야. 참아 이시지 않냐 이시기 여러분. 이기시 비장 계시지 않냐 이시기 여러분. 하고서.
나.
나도 노래. 샘다
So the point is that just this exploration of the brain and the nerve system and the processes in the brain, that in itself didn't do so much good. Yeah? So what actually is necessary is an exploration of consciousness, or which is a mental phenomenon, mental consciousness, this is again referring to the presentation of mind, mental factors, everything we have in Lorik, in knowledge and awareness, this whole topic. So this is actually necessary to be kind of added on this exploration of the brain and so forth in order to bring the full benefit. And so what we need to aim for, therefore, is a knowledge or an education with regard to the realm of the mental phenomena that is coming together with knowledge about the science of physical phenomena, yeah, like of atoms and so forth. Yeah? So therefore, as this is the actual aim, yeah, that this part of the realm of the mental phenomena also needs to be part of the education, needs to be combined with normal or traditional science, then here, this is then the meaning when it was said we should enter into science. And so therefore, if we would come so far that we have a science that is analyzing the outer and the inner, yeah, so this kind of analysis, this kind of science, yeah, then really here we would have something in the human society that really can bring great benefit to everybody in the society, yeah, both analyzing and understanding external phenomena, the external conditions, and also the inner state of mind and so forth, the realm of the mental phenomena. So from both of these combined, then a great benefit can be achieved for the sentient beings. And so therefore, this would then be a science that is sufficient. Yeah? Right now it's insufficient, but if it is supplemented like this or develops into such an analysis of the outer and the inner, then it would be sufficient for bringing about great benefit for all the beings, all the human beings and all the beings. And so therefore, this kind of imagined or future science, this should be brought about. And in order for this to come about, yeah, here this text was composed, this to generate or to work towards such a science coming about in the future is the first aim of His Holiness.
Today in the Sanje be chulu. Nangwe chulu de da, so da, tsenri yin ki para,
So then talking about the second aim of His Holiness, so He says...
So we're not talking about the second aim
of His Holiness, but he said now what is His first aim, and now He's developing the thought further, leading to the second one. So He says that in general, science can learn a lot from the Buddha Dharma, and the Buddha Dharma can learn a lot from science. Or somebody who is studying the Buddha Dharma can learn a lot from science, and science can learn a lot from studying the Buddha Dharma. So there's this mutual kind of support in understanding things, and therefore we should also do that. And it is very clear with regard to ourselves that we are not just physical beings, we are not just a body. Yeah, it is clear that we have inside, we have feelings, we have perceptions, we are conscious and so forth. Yeah? So there is a consciousness part to us as well, we are not just the body. So that being the case, then what we need is an education and an understanding and knowledge with regard to both the body and the inner phenomena, the mind. Yeah, so up to now, we are provided with an education that tells us about the body only. Yeah, the outer phenomenon, if you like, or the physical phenomenon of the body. Only that is what we're receiving as education. And so then, if people would understand what are the inner aspects of generating happiness and joy, yeah, to come to an experience of happiness and joy, so this would be really kind of the education, they would know about that, yeah, and then having this knowledge together with the knowledge about outer or physical phenomena, then here this would be something that is very beneficial for them. So therefore, this is really something that we should aim for, an education that is teaching both about the outer and the inner. Yeah? So by knowing this, then they would be able to achieve their aim of joy and happiness or well-being. And so this is something that should be founded. Yeah? It has not been, is not here yet, but this is like almost like founding a new system. Yeah? A new epoch in science should start. We should found this new school kind of thing. Yeah? This new system of education that has both aspects.
Draw me digi juvela, dungesayala, 생각을 좀 받아 시제 네가 세리 되기도 고도 쓴 거야 당 아주라 네 네가 좀 봐이나 네가 중화들이 당 알아서 강의 세트고도 쓴 거야 내들 시고도 쓰러
And so this seems to be aiming at people who are Buddhists. Yeah, so they know maybe somewhere about the Buddha Dharma. So therefore, the presentation of how to deal with the mind mental factors and so forth. So they know how to deal with the inner phenomena. But in order to achieve this complete welfare of all beings and also for oneself maybe, one needs to kind of also include science. So even if you are a Buddhist and you're studying these different presentations about the mind and mental factors and so forth, it is very necessary, very very useful to also kind of incorporate studies of science within this study of Buddhism, because if this can be combined, then here the welfare of everybody or the well-being of everybody can be achieved.
타두그 미유데 가라에서나 다 친구보 야게다야다 나 생각 리바드게 야게다야네 냠도 줘야 되래서 다
So then his holiness also was explaining how indeed there is a more and more understanding about this this outer phenomena in traditional science, but the goal must be to bring these two together, this knowledge about the phenomena, which is referring to outer phenomena, and this knowledge of the realm of the mental phenomena.
Then zomni chi shenye tirik senan zomni chi shenye rupchadarwa. Wodi na shenye senkan rupa tina chune, Nyamdo sungri dhanjwaayachi, zamni chi shenye dhu chutwaayachi, di sungudu, miyu di sungudu sungudu.
And so we can say that in the world, on our planet, science has become a general education, a general knowledge. Yeah? So here, the aim would be to aim for kind of this new science, where you're combining, where you have a union of this knowledge about outer phenomena and also a knowledge of inner phenomena or of the mental phenomena, yeah, the realm of the mental phenomena. And this kind of combined science, this union of both aspects, that this kind of science then becomes a general education on the planet and becomes a general knowledge of everybody on the planet. And so this is the second aim that His Holiness is expressing, and then we make a break. For 20 minutes. So I asked Geshe we had several people came to me saying, what's the difference between the first objective and the second? And so I asked Geshe if he could clarify this, and he said, well, I'm going to explain the second one now. So if I said that there was already a second one, seemingly it was not. Like that.
Tangbo digi ne de zong da de ka le sna. Cheni daro ne sun ta da ba do. Chingobola, Taja Tochigidos. Then, Tela then a yaket, Shushdanshas. Chingoba yaket, Shushdanshas. Yine young, Naraz me kangi chung chim those. Naraz draw me digi. Digicheron dredge down, don't make new dredge. Tado chumundus. Janzochi sentiments. Come as some rest, no? Nasamble yagged and summons. Della Sankanshi but chukutus. Then you need the Sungri de Chimbayena. Then then Anzoge and Dora Kembashi, then they young to rest. Daddy Dodo turned out Dodo the chin did. That's the same thing.
So what happened up to now was that it was expressed how from the very start until today, science was aiming only for this outer phenomena or for this physical phenomena and analyzing this. And they got very far with this. And so while this is the case, we can see that within our society, happiness has not really been achieved. And also the suffering has not been diminished. Yeah, so therefore, or the lack of happiness has not been diminished, and so this is a clear sign of something lacking. Yeah, the situation is not sufficient; it's not it's wanting; it's lacking, and so so therefore, what needs to be added is such a science of the realm of the inner phenomena, the mental phenomena. And so therefore what we would aim for is such a combination or union, combination of a science that knows about the outer phenomena and also knows about inner phenomena. Because if this would come about, such a combination, then on the basis of this, that what is wished for by everybody in society could actually be achieved. Yeah, so by knowing about the outer phenomena, but also knowing about inner states and how happiness comes about, connect to inner states, then here this actually can achieve what we wanted to achieve, which was the well-being of the of everybody, of all beings.
How was that? And
so, together with this, the situation in the world today is that science is somebody that everybody has interest in. So science is regarded very highly by everybody, and this then manifests in worldwide the general education being about science. Yeah? So in other words, this what science is standing for, what science does, what science knows, becomes very vastly and widely spread in the general education worldwide. So therefore, if it if you could achieve that science becomes more complete by including such a knowledge or a science of inner phenomena, of mental phenomena, then also that knowledge would become widespread. Yeah? If it becomes a part of science and everybody has a high regard for science, it will become a general education worldwide. So then this knowledge about the mental realm would become a knowledge worldwide for all sentient beings. And so this is one aspect.
Mm-hmm.
So up to now, all of this was actually the first objective, the first aim of His Holiness. So now, from here now, there starts the second one.
Mm-hmm.
Now in this section, His Holiness is talking about how the human beings are experiencing all kind of problems, and within this manifold, this mass of problems, we can actually discern two types. So one is a type of problem that is produced or brought about actually by the humans themselves. It's kind of a man-made problems for the human beings. And the other ones are kind of natural problems, natural difficulties. So this, for example, is related to the elements. Yeah. So like, for example, an earthquake and so forth. Yeah. So this is another type of calamity or problem that can happen to human beings, which is not man-made, but it is naturally, it's coming from nature. It's connected to the elements and so forth. And this second one, these natural ones, will be very, very difficult. It's difficult to see how human beings could stop these. But the other one, which is called the man-made problems, then as it is said that they are made by men, then also men can stop them. Yeah? The human beings bring forth certain problems, so the human beings can stop these problems.
Mm-hmm.
So in general, in society, when we look at the state of education, we can say that nowadays we have a good level of education.
Mm-hmm.
So while this is the case, then it seems like however much education we get, these human problems are still with us. So what does this tell us? It tells us that this very good level of education that we have today, yeah, is not sufficient for eliminating these human problems. So this naturally leads to the question, so if we have this education and still we have all these human problems, if we still are not achieving the happiness that we're looking for and we are not able to stop, eliminate or avoid any kind of suffering while we have all this education, then what is it? What's missing? Yeah, what's not sufficient? What is it exactly? Yeah, what do we have to look for? Yeah? In other words, what would be the source of all these problems? And so His Holiness is identifying that there is these sources for the human problems which are coming from self-cherishing. Yeah, this is a source. Then attachment and desire is a source. Then anger is a source. Then having wishes kind of being unsatiable. Yeah, you never know that it's enough. You're never in a state where you say, like, okay, now I have enough. Yeah, you have always more wishes. This is a source. Then being partial, making clear distinctions, this is my side, this is your side. Yeah, so this kind of clear distinctions is a source. Jealousy is a source. And then all kinds of forms of pride or arrogance, yeah, also that is a source. And so all of these in a very strong form. And so what is the kind of from the other side in comparison with this list of sources would be a mind that is cherishing others, you could say like an altruism, yeah? And then also a mind of a loving attitude or an affectionate attitude, a compassionate attitude, a mind of patience, a mind that wants to be conscientious and ethical. Yeah? You could try to work with the expression, a mind that wants to be virtuous. And so all of these factors is something that we are lacking, yeah? which is really missing. So therefore, as these are missing, we would need an education that brings about that we have these factors. And so therefore, So then, therefore, with regard to a view or like an attitude, an outlook, what we need to gain is what is technically called an understanding or a penetrative insight, coming to a decisive conclusion with regard to what is to be adopted and what is to be discarded. Yeah, so factors that need to be discarded are all these previous ones. Yeah, like self-cherishing, anger, and so forth. And what is to be adopted is this altruism, this love, this patience, and so forth. So these factors. So this is something that we need to be clear about. We need to get a clear understanding. We need to penetrate this presentation. What is to be discarded, what we need to get rid of, and what we need to gain, what we need to adopt. Yeah. So the point is that in our education, in our own life, we would come to such a clear understanding, yeah, have the clear attitude, the clear view, what we need to get rid of and what we need to get, what we need to gain, what we need to adopt. Then there is no doubt that the man-made problems will disappear. So when we talk about the present day's general education, and we said before that this is talking about science in the traditional way of looking mainly out on external phenomena, material phenomena, manipulating the external world, then we need to ask ourselves, so what's the purpose? What is this science aiming at? What they try to achieve? And what they try to achieve is indeed benefit of the human beings on the planet. Yeah? They really want to benefit.
Tim
And so if you look at this advancement in science and see what they brought to us, then we can see that there was a great improvement in the area of medicine. Yeah, so the whole way we have hospitals today, what the doctors know, how they can heal, medicines available and so forth, great improvement there. Then we have another aspect of actually protecting the environment. Yeah? Also this is very much possible through science. Then you have another aspect of, how we say this, transmuting, yeah, like by planes, cars, streets, trains, and so forth. Yeah? So people are able to move about, yeah? Due to, like, cover great distances, and be connected and so forth, due to science. Then also you can see that the very basic necessities of life, like food and drink, yeah, all of this also got improved by science. And also people are connected to each other in the sense of communicating. Yeah? There's communication lines, there's all kind of new forms of talking to each other, communicating with each other, and so forth. All of these things have been greatly improved by science.
Running is a kanya car. Tadunya ranchas net, yes, what?
Me sube tangarang jung chung nigger.
Me sube kanya de, perachasanga, rather, me sube kanya de, Tadunya ranchanet, yes.
Ah, Roger. So this is the case, and at the same time, also all these human-produced problems are still present. Yeah, so all these are just there like before. And so, if you look even into societies which are very well developed or countries which are very well off, then even in these societies you will find that there is people who are stealing. There's thieves. There is robbers, yeah? Or let's say people who are, how do you call this? Anyway, thugs which are really using violence might even kill somebody, or how do you call this? Abduct somebody? Anyway, these kind of people. There's murder going on. There's murderers. You have people shooting around with guns, with rifles and so forth. People using poison on others and so forth. Things happen to ships, to airplanes and so forth. So all of these things are still happening. And then you have all these sufferings which are depending on the mind, yeah, mental sufferings, mental problems, and all of these are still around. Yeah? So with all this scientific improvement, we still have all these aspects still present in even the well-developed societies. And as in our own continuum, we still have this state of never being satisfied, yeah? Being unsatiable, then having anger, having jealousy, being full of arrogance and pride and so forth. So in this kind of state, you can go out and buy external phenomena as much as you want, and you will not become happy or satisfied.
That is choshe senda. Because choshe ba, chamze. What in the summer in Alala, chigiona? Chamze than damage, choshe than damage, chigiona, you know?
So on the other hand, if you have somebody who has this mind, who is easily satisfied or knows when it's enough, yeah, can be satisfied. A person who has in this continuum a loving attitude, affection, compassion, and so forth, then completely natural, as a natural effect, this person is in peace, is pacified, is somebody who is subdued or disciplined, or in the sense of kind of subdued, let's say. Yeah? So a subdued, peaceful person. So this naturally comes about. And so then, if you have somebody with these factors, who is the naturally pacified, naturally subdued, you could say is a positive person, is a friendly person, a gentle person, and so forth. Yeah. So then, somebody in that state, even if the outside conditions are not so good, this person will stay in this pacified state and being subdued and being generally happy. Yeah? So this being the case, then we can see how these disqualities of the mind are actually of outstanding importance. So therefore the situation is now like that. You have suffering or uneasiness with regard to the body. So here the scientists can help a lot. But then with regard to inner states, then with regard to different attitudes and so forth that we might have, then here any kind of factor of love and compassion, yeah, compassionate or loving, affectionate aspects that human beings have, yeah, this is something that we should increase more and more, getting to higher and higher levels. And so therefore, within society, to cultivate, like that each and every member of society cultivates in this continuum, love, affection, compassionate attitude, and so forth, yeah? This being a root for happiness, then it becomes something that we can actually not do without. We need to have this factor in our mind.
And then you do...
And so therefore, if the scientists would do experiments or exploration, examination into this area that is described normally within the folder of knowledge about mental phenomena, the mental realm, then here there would be great benefit come from this kind of analysis, detailed analysis.
Samlo nada yerup chwa yerup chasans
yerup la na
yerup
yerup
yapo da rap to pyu chimba
yagrap
na yaraba midi yarab shwish to slabdi khala uda slada yerup sa digi ko shiga jambo tu ko samlo ta da yago tu milinyora langmindu dine wada ne yarab sa dilago yarba ra
One can talk about a person being excellent and outstanding. Yeah? So Geshe used a certain phrase in Tibetan. Kind of marvelous person, yeah, like kind of positive and outstanding. So this is talking about somebody who has a very gentle, positive character, whose way of thinking, yeah, his thoughts, his attitudes are also very helpful, very very positive, and is somebody who doesn't make problems to anyone. Yeah, so such a person, positive and excellent, yeah. If many of these arise within society, great benefit, of course, for the society.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact is simply that we need in our society people like this, people with this kind of character and so forth. And so that being the case, then the scientists are also quite interested in these topics.
That cerebral digital tonatiba, you know, cerebral cronsola, cerebral nalala, never shows your aggress. Cere yaket wag. Never, how was on?
Ali, cendri grong, I mean, cendri body, susula, penuris.
Cere chimoba yagel than the digit, caught digit to the chigorba. Shazan, when a krang and dovana shingi, that ya tuya the langa nigris krang. How was on?
And so if a scientist would explore this, yeah, then these factors of how to become such an outstanding person's good qualities, then there would be great benefit for the scientist or for science itself as well. Because, as it was already said, the science is actually undertaken in order to bring benefit and happiness and well-being to all the human beings. And so here we have something that is exactly achieving that, what the scientists are aiming for. So if the scientists show this interest in these methods for becoming such an excellent and outstanding person, yeah, very beneficial and so forth, then here that means that they show interest in this presentation of knowledge of the mental realm. Then here we can actually give something to the scientists, which is like a great gift to them, because then by understanding this, they can integrate this within to science and give more methods to the sentient beings that they are actually aiming for, that they attain well-being and happiness. So up to now, when we talk about these factors of love and compassion that are useful here to for the mental states, so this is factors that the scientists have up to now not explored much. So what is science actually good for? What's the purpose of it?
Draw me. Coca-Cola tene chumorvas. Draw me la karakugido.
So the science has come into existence on the basis of certain needs that the human beings had. Yeah, the human beings needed certain things, and then science developed something in order to fulfill this need.
Draw me la la.
So then the question would be, so as this is connected to the needs of sentient beings, so what is the greatest need of human beings? Because there is a great need from the side of the humans, of the beings, of everybody, and science is kind of separated from that and does something else, yeah, not related to this great need, then there is no benefit in science.
Chiri, tadub, samuyede, chulu chida, chulu, 다와다 춘다 야고 유댕 슈루치다 지라도 남아 산게베 다 슝네 다 송에게 생감기 지바 세디 아선스 좋아 미베 거거 최셔 차대 열었어 봐
And so here with regard to this well-established system of view and then also achievings, which is this Buddha Dharma, yeah, this Buddha Dharma is indeed aiming at this highest need or this most urgent or greatest need of the sentient beings and is able to achieve that.
Never so egg. Tapshi, that shila. She never pardon last of the name. Same chung studi. That root doesn't several years.
So the point is that all that what is destroying the problems falls in the mind and is actually leading it to higher and higher states, yeah, like, methods like calm abiding, special insight, then all this different ways of improving the mind more and more. All of this is clearly spelled out in the view and the way to practice of Buddhism.
Dada yeshi me geshi.
And so with regard to improving this the mind of sentient beings and how to achieve this and what are the different processes to train the mind and so forth, all of this is clearly present here in this system or this presentation, the view and the achieving of Buddha Dharma. And so therefore the scientists who are interested in that field, or actually scientists in general, who are interested in bringing about the welfare of sentient beings, of human beings, should look at what is presented here.
What's in the Dona Yuna? What does Sankar Shiba? Jumadish, which gets him rashas, what?
Sandy, but tends to curry. And so the point can be then brought in a nutshell, saying like if somebody is interested in science, he should have interest in this presentation of the mental phenomena. And so the point is that we need to pacify the mental problems of the human beings, of the sentient beings, and so this needs to be understood, the process of these sufferings and how they can be pacified. And so in order to work with these hindrances or obstacles in the mind, then here in the presentation of this the Buddhist system, there's many methods presented of how to deal with these problems. And so the point is that if somebody has all these tools, knows about these methods, how to deal with the mind and how to bring forth happiness and so forth, then he should try to work towards bringing this into the general education or general knowledge of everybody in society.
Mm-hmm.
And so, therefore, the second objective is that here there will be a change towards all beings having kind of access to these tools, to this education, with regard to how to improve their situation.
What is it? This generation, that's what it is. I rather me chizo na la kar kudo sila de chungo ba yage kudo. Seri laja de ngan zu kudo. De samke ngan zu doa me gogo gojen sama zu tu gumindo ngan zu dunge da do mutu ne negi do ne deisha. Seri yage shiwo chin de jigab na la taran do ransha do. Nyora langi mangu do. Adanya ini, ta, ngan tu nala kaya sana, ta nasi samri agak dah, kita terpisah tu kudu. Orang na, sate, senggam ribat dengan tu, mici senyap dah kaya terpisah tu kudu, semua.
And so the point is that when we talk about the needs of sentient beings and the aims that they try to achieve and so forth, they try to accomplish, to try to accrue, we can see that there is one part that is clearly connected with outer conducive conditions. And all of this can clearly be aided for or provided for even by science, traditional science. Yeah? So that's very clear. At the same time, we see that many human problems, like these man-made problems, are still with us. And within our society, we have many people who make a lot of problems to others and so forth. So we can see that this is still the case. So therefore here, the point here is that the science as it is up to now is not complete, is not sufficient, so it should kind of be supplemented by adding a part that is a science about the mental realm, yeah, the knowledge about the mental phenomena, and then this should become a part of the general education so that everybody has access to this knowledge.
Chazan. 当俺那时候连接开了要得是呢，俺那时候连接开了要得是了不对。没他妈南瓜吃过的是呢，有啥过要嘛？南瓜吃要嘛？对。怎么连接呢？没同桌，同桌是要得，开心多啊。呀。怎么连呢？没同桌。同桌。同桌搞这那个，俺那时候别个人同桌是他同桌，同桌他妈要得。没同桌同桌要得，家家里家家里就送上去要得。
동주를 주소는 지어래 사야 갸탐바
Somebody, 되네 동주 사야 가면 사야 동다지 세게 말해
동규치
아 동주주
그래 미보 동규 뒤로 동주
뒤주
뒤주 원래 오케이
점리나 밑에 둔주
오케이
뒤나 둔주는 점 패진 점을 찌 이걸 지전 찌여 말해 찌여 말해
유슨
말 찌여 말해 갸탕발 사이 갸탕발 둔주 찌로 와 점을 지전 점을 둔주 거들 사이 개주도
가 사야 개주 인사래
개주 인사라 개미를 가지 하고서
Tung
karina chö chigmeseng mi tungju chusu yorsigdwa. Jan digir tsangwa namba chagwasin yoye ho yomarwa. Dile namba chö nang tsenrik namshadi. Pam zemli chi sheng dezana palu tuwa chuna. Gyaurum chit miyu dirwa. Odi palu tuwa chuna misama donatawa na misama ta karchigirasana. Chingubu yagen duwada nyamdola. Nasambo yagen dudus. Jazan tarange din zamlina shidi shidi jumbal pingdus. What is ngorwa?
Don't you din zlanga chu chula kuni
dona chimdus. Da dignalda chuga chimdus. Da tujul hason. Tujulanda yishu kazu yare. Kaji kazu yare. Hindu kazu yare. Chijin Hindu niba dingre. Kaji. Then Jewish. Then nangbaire.
And so the point is simply that when we talk about these methods that the Buddha Dharma has to offer in order to change the mind, to deal with the problems the man-made or the problems in the mind and so forth, yeah, then obviously we would say like, well, then take the Buddha Dharma, you know. But this is definitely not going to happen. It's not that the population of this planet all going to change into Buddhists. It's not like that. Yeah? If you look at what's actually going on, we have 7 billion people living on this planet. Yeah? 1 billion out of these 7 billion is completely atheist in the sense of like, I don't want to even listen to anything that is religion. Yeah? Don't even listen to this. So you have only 6 billion left for people who are even kind of doing something with Dharma. So how many of these are Christian? How many are Muslim? Then you have Hindus, and the Hindus are a lot. Maybe they're even the second biggest. Maybe then the Muslims. Then there's also other religions like the Jewish religion and so forth. So all of these also are not going to become Buddhist. So this is not what we're aiming for. We're not aiming for that everybody becomes Buddhist. Yeah, His Holiness has as an objective here is that this understanding of the mental realm, of the mental phenomena, should enter into general science and by this spread to everybody. Because there's no way of everybody kind of entering into the Buddha Dharma. So these things need to be taken and be kind of presented to the scientists and through the scientists enter into science and then become part of the general education.
Not it.
And so here there is this is kind of a plan or a hope that in this kind of process there can be achieved great benefit into society. And so also in general we can say that those of us, those people, like for example us, ourselves, who are studying the Buddha Dharma, should also look at science. We need to enter into science. And so then here you can listen to people who say like the world is round or spheric, or other people say the world is flat, and other people say the world is square and stuff like this, you know. Does that matter? Not the topic. The topic is how to achieve happiness and destroy suffering. This is the topic. And here, the question is simply, is happiness coming by only relying on outer phenomena, outer situations? But it is not. And so therefore, there is a necessity, there's a need for methods of working with the mind. And here, Buddhism has a lot to offer as a gift, as a help, as a support to all the human beings, to all of society, to all the world. And so this is what we're talking about. And we're not talking about the shape of the world, how it is, and blah, 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 our kind of worldviews and everything. We talk about these mental tools, yeah, and how we can give these to science, and maybe through science, to all the world.
Oh, that made it a bit. She was powerful, kola zujudu, kola mweshe, kola chishishidu. Hale! 지 말아야 돼. 내가 가서 가르쳐도 그렇지. 나도 가르펜도 있대. 나치 펜도 요 말이지. 봐. 나도 펜도데 아, 생각하지 남자다 신지 미치도 되게 에 가서다. 겨울음 짓으면 순 순수와 라친지. 와. 콘조. 대응함시 뭐. 난 차도 어디를 다들만 망고 순수. 되게든 좋다.
And then somebody might say, like, this person here can send forth emanations. This person here has clairvoyances. Then what? Where's the benefit from this to us? Yeah? What is actually presented as a problem by His Holiness is having self-cherishing, having an unsatiable wish for more and more things, never being content, having anger, being full of attachment, never knowing when it's enough, being jealous, having pride and arrogance. Yeah? These are problems, and for this we need answers. And there is answers for this. And the answer is not that this one has emanations and this one has clairvoyances. So, for example, His Holiness is on all occasions saying, I don't have any of these. There's a reason why He says this. The reason is because there's no benefit from these. So therefore, we talk here about this field of knowledge, about the realm of the mind. Yeah? Knowing, understanding, the knowledge of mental phenomena. So you're here all studying exactly this kind of science, this kind of knowledge. Yeah? And the point here made is simply that you're studying this in order to carry this into society. This is what it's for. And then maybe we can stop here for today. Geshe feels that maybe it was already too much for everybody. How you feel?
He sent a message. How was that?
A lingua.
That didn't my language. How was that?
So, what we have here, of course, is His Holiness speaking himself in this portion of the text. Yeah? And so, he's in this text, he's actually giving a message, and Geshe is trying to convey this message to all of us.
What I did not know, Deb Ketchage, and this is Nindus, right?
And in the whole series, there's two volumes like this, which are the most important part of the whole series. This is this text that we're talking about. And so Geshe wants to say that what is presented here is all coming from the Gangyur. Even more so from the Dengur. Yeah? So the Gangyur is the collection of the sutras of spoken by the Buddha himself, and then Dengur is the collection of the treatises. So especially from the Dengur, from the treatises, these are the sources for what is presented in these texts.
And so,
therefore, as you are all studying the Buddha Dharma, if in the future you should end up in a situation where you encounter a scientist, yeah, do so with a lot of confidence. Yeah? Clearly knowing, I can answer to this person. Whatever he's saying, whatever question he's asking, I have an answer for this person. And I'm answering to somebody who is thinking, somebody who is using logic. I got to give him an answer with reason. Yeah? I'm going to prove things.
Uh-huh.
So then there is you can have this blessing strings around your neck or around your wrist and so forth. So a scientist comes to you and says, so you bear this stuff around your neck and around your wrist, how does this benefit? What are you going to say? Can you explain that? David can explain it. Somebody has a mic? How would you explain it?
Yeah, tige chi la gudus la no kubel la gares de da na sun so.
La. Mare kong 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 di gune, den di tongne gen kong geberun buji tingi du. Den geberun geberun ji ki yunden. Ka yunden tingi du. Den di kong la pingi du.
Ka pingi du.
How does it help you to remember the good qualities of His Holiness? Yeah, no, but how does it, the question is not how does this help you to remember the good qualities, but how do the good qualities of holiness or remembering that help you? Then what's the benefit of faith? I have trust in you. I have belief in you. What does this benefit him? So the faith is such that you think that if His Holiness has attained these attainments that He has attained, maybe I can also attain that. What good qualities does His Holiness have achieved? Huh? He's a good human being. Me Sangburis. Me Sangburis. Me Yabudu.
This Sangbu Kiraji.
But this being a good human being is something that you need to do. You need to be a good human being. So he's a good
man.
So in order to be a good person, what you need to do is you need to destroy this kind of afflictions that were listed here. And you have to kind of look into this book. So Geshe was asking me if this text actually exists in English, yeah? And so I don't know, I haven't seen it. Probably yes. Geshe says that His Holiness directly related to him that it exists in English already. So some people observed that they checked in the internet, I guess, and could not find any, get any results. And so Geshe wonders if maybe it has not been published yet. So Geshe is suggesting that I said to him like that we would need the English title, yeah, because I can translate this title into English, but I don't know if it's probably, huh?
Give it a shot. Try.
What?
Translated in English.
I did already. I gave it to somebody. Who is it? Where is it? It's gone. So okay, it's something like the compendium of the present of the mode of abidance, or the presentation, or the reality of the basis the basic phenomena and the view and establishment as explained from Buddhist texts. I'm sure you don't get this on the internet. Yeah? So therefore, it's going to be a little bit different like this. So anyway, Geshe simply said, like, why don't you contact Thubten Chimba and ask him if it has been published?
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe you, if anyone has connection with Geshe Tashi, yeah, then it's pretty clear that Geshe Tashi would know about this and has connection also with Tupten Chimpa. So that's clear. So this is also another way to do it.
I have some related with a book called The Universe in a Single Atom, The Convergence of Science and Spirituality.
This is not this one, this is another one. No. This is a talk with some Vietnamese or something, some scientist. Yeah, but it's together. Anyway, it's not this. This one exists since a long time. This is around since some time already.
This series of books is a compilation of Gambia and Lingua in Bible. Is it directly by
Islam? Uh-huh. Okay, that's quite important, yeah. Den tanda kare gündü dira gündü din kare dangyo tang dengyo katsu yuna di tabo di di na gündü duber wa di gündü du ken di su yina di gebere mo gündü duber be su di
jaurum je tsogo su yaras ta tsogo di na la la geshe mone geshe ya mo je geshe tamo ne mo shi geshe ya mo je mengai ni shi yes
控制龙龙十四二十七把是搞来讲的，听那老的，听那在呢，啥嘛？嗯，那确实晓得是的。So the person who did the compilation was not His Holiness himself. His Holiness formed a committee or a group of scholars. So within that, there were like 5, 6 or something scholars, and they were really kind of very excellent scholars. Yeah, and so these were scanning through all this Gangyo and Tengyo for 4 to 5 years. Yeah, and in this way, they came up with this text. So Geshe actually has connection with all of these Geshes, yeah, because there's this wonderful provided thing from Western science, which is called WeChat. So via WeChat, he is connected with all these geshes.
Yeah. Okay, and this again.
Maybe they would know the title. Tere kare geshe tenso kare WeChat ni kare tenso jen inji tola di shingyore.
Geshe to inji shingmaris.
So this
is... Tez shingyores.
La.
Tez shingyores. Ne shira shingmaris. Ine da, kunso biyu tona sonya derwa. Da riji tsokochik inji tona sugyaro. Tsokochik dayi tona sugyaro. Da dini...
So these geshes don't really know much English. Yeah? A little bit they do, but not much. And this is also because their job was to provide the Tibetan text, and they did everything in Tibetan and scanned through the text and so forth. And then there were other groups which were translating it into English, and another group translating it into Chinese. And then in the future there should be also kind of groups to do it into French and to other languages and so forth.
Mm. Ah. Changju Sanjo Rambo, Chiraswa,